versus DDPJ, and this is our BO3 second match.
This is the second match indeed, and this is a do or die for RRQ Oxygen. Unless they want to stick with the third or fourth position, which I really don't want, but the shield isn't gold, so the bronze is it. So that's wood.
And it's gonna start right now, immediately.
So you'll get the wood plating for. What if you get gold in like the fourth position, you know?
Mm.
But you, so instead of like the gold in first position, you get like the gold shield in the fourth position, and then like silver, then like bronze and wood for the first. You know, it's they just look like reverse. But anyways, joking aside, we're gonna go right into the first game, and it's gonna be Harley on Tsutsuru, and Liam is gonna play Hylos as well as Instinct will be playing Huckart, not gonna get banned there. Lemon will be playing the Jawhead, not the Assassin, as Ayam Jago is gonna be Mardis, as on the digital level side, Liu is gonna play Lancelot, Tuts is gonna play Akai. Yako will be playing that Alpha, Lolita, and Gushin is gonna play. It's gonna be played by the Zania again, another Gushin. And look at that, Pew is gonna play a lot of damage. He's gonna give a lot of damage right onto Hylos with that Lancelot. And Lancelot is not bad, not so perfect either. But Lemon just got a kill with that Jawhead. Wow.
It's really, really strong now. RRQ have a lot at stake here. They have to win twice here to be qualified for a grand final. Meanwhile, DD only have to win once to be qualified. And now a little bit of Tom and Jerry action here. Tutor almost get caught here when he entered the bush here. Harley rocking him with the cards. Have to retreat back and clear out the minion here at the mid lane. And so Lolita is just scouting around the bushes on the bot lane. I am jungle. And the rest of the team is going up on to the top lane. 3 versus 2 out there. They are just waiting for the right time. Ted just got caught with the Nom there. But yeah.
Yeah, the fight is still not happening. They're trying to play a bit safe after the first two kills from each. The first two kills from both sides.
Yep.
And it's still not gonna do a lot of stuff, at least on the gold lead either, because it's still pretty much the same, only 100 difference. That's just 3 minions difference. But look at that, Lemon is trying to fling one away as Few is gonna get flanked from behind. There is a Dark Knight, but to no avail. Instinct was unable to save Lemon there, and Lemon will have to go down. It's 2 kills right now for Real Devils, and it's gonna be a chance for them to get the first turtle.
So DDPG is going to initiate the turtle now, probably without any contest. RRQ doesn't really notice that they are going for the turtle there. RRQ just roaming around in their own lane here, not knowing that the turtle just got taken there. And so clearing out the minions, both party is going to meet in the mid lane. 3 versus 3 there. Lancelot is quite near. Oh, Tets is getting caught there.
There is an early game right onto Tets, but it's not going to deal enough damage, as there is going to be the ultimate coming from Jawhead. Will try to rush it out, but Few is going to get captured instead, as Mardis is going to pick up that kill. Few with the Lancelot is going to go down. I am Jago will pick up that kill instead.
No proxy game, proxy farming as of right now. They're quite equal in terms of gold here. Only 500 gold difference between the two of them. Quite negligible at this time of point. We are 3 and a half minutes in. There's no movement here. 70 seconds to turtle as well. And if you guys are watching on our Facebook Live, go support DD Gaming Philippines or Indonesia. Oh, John!
There is a Rugen Dance, but he is getting hit by the deadly game. Look at the damage coming from the deadly game and follow up instantly by I Am Jago with the Mardis Astral Strike onto the Mortal Coil. However, the Tornadoes is right there with the Phantom Solution. Nomnon Blast with the Lolita, but won't hit anyone as Ayam Jago will try to escape. There is a Mortal Coil again, stunning 3 people at once, but will not help him survive that fight, as he is gonna go down 1 for 1. Tets for Ayam Jago. But look at that in bot lane, as Instinct here is gonna almost die. Deadly Poison, sorry, my bad. I got lost in the fight and all of the beautiful
scenery.
Not scenery, I mean like the lights and effects from the skills. But the little singer was unable to deal enough damage there.
But I mean, things are not going as aggressively as I wanted it to be. I mean, I know that there's a lot of things at stake here for both teams. So anyone who is going to proceed after the semifinal will go into the grand final to fight either main here from the Philippines. So either it will be the Indonesian versus Philippines or Philippines versus Philippines.
And the first turret, at least, on the RRQ side has been destroyed, but there's going to be another return turret kill on top lane, and the turtle is going to get slain again by a few. That is two turtles, four Digital Devils, and RRQ still has no objective. This has been going on since the first game as well, and it's going to be going a bit bad. However, the goalie is still there as Unsink actually flashes away from that fight. And look at that sense. Will Hurricane Dance out of the way, saving his life, but there's not going to be another Hurricane Dance for at least another 1 minute, and that is going to be a lot of issue as RRQ here is going to gather around for another fight. Liam there is already there, will try to do the stun, but will just run away. There is a mortal hold to save his life as Liam is not in any kind of danger though. Instinct will try to farm, funnel farming here, get as much gold as possible going into the mid game.
So both Martis and also Jawhead is building an all damage dealer build here, similar to Lancelot, as you can see from DDPG here. They're slowly building up their items here to fight against it. Oh, I am Jago, have to get caught there, almost die.
Oh,
Hylos.
The glorious bat way right there, and there is, however, the Nominon Blast, but Liam will have damage to Lamin for the damage who just comes in after Jawhead, after Alpha die. But look at that, there is Dark Dance right onto Martis as I Am Jago will have to fall down.
I Am Jago was alone there. Tuturu wasn't able to come into that war because of his skills cooldown. Quite a shame, but you have to be really careful now. DDPG already have their scaling right, they have killed quite a lot, 4-7 now, and they are slowly snowballing here. We have to see what RRQ can do to come back from this.
Would you call a snowball? Or is it like slowly getting the goalie?
It's like you're putting it in a fridge and
like
you're waiting
slowly,
it to become
right,
an ice,
yeah,
and then you make it as
well. So you like roll it slowly.
Yeah,
like,
roll it super slowly.
Gotcha.
So 8 minutes in, we still haven't seen like a huge war happening here. I was expecting it to be more aggressive from DDPG because they have slightly less things to worry for now.
Interestingly though, even though the fight has been on DDPG side, oh never mind, there is going to be a fight here as Q will have to run away with the Phantom Execution. However, the Zoro's dealt enough damage, there is a Ghost Batway, but it only gives a bit of health, extra health to Hylos, but Hylos will save a lot of here as Liam will run away. But look at that, everybody else is going to get captured. There is the Nominon Blast to the Flicker, and Tuturu will try to deal a lot of damage with that Poker Trick. SD will be able to escape that. And, sorry, gone.
Yako just now was just split pushing it, so the other team, the other teammate from DDPG is just providing enough distraction for it. Q is going to take that turret.
Deadly game right onto that poker stick. Never mind.
Oh, that's
it's
so
too much. Yeah,
little.
The damage wasn't even that high. As you were saying, Alpha was actually solo pushing in bot lane, whereas the fight actually happened. Yako has been doing that over and over, actually trying to seal as much jungle minions for so Hellcart doesn't get. Fed doesn't snowball in that gold, because honestly the only reason why RRQ is still able to hold into a 2k deficit is because that Nominon Blast to Phantom Execution to the Hurricane Dance will able to get the double kill, but there is hardly able to kill Yako. However, the Samia will get that kill with the Shadow Blast Slaughter right onto Martis.
RRQ, you have to go back here. Your teammates really need you. The tier 3 turret half. Will go down pretty time soon. We have to go down by Harley here. Top lane turret has been destroyed.
Instinct though, however, tried to flicker away. There is the Shadow Blade. There's the Shadow Blink right there. The blink that, no, what do you call it? The Shadow Strike.
Oh, Shadow Strike, yeah.
No, I need to look that up.
And of course that is a really worth it war that they already got the tier 3 turrets from RRQ. They have to push,
it's
or
the
just
spike.
Okay, and they have to take the Lord so that it will be easier for them to push the other lane. But RRQ, what is going on?
Honestly,
Hellcurt and also Liam was chasing down other members of the Digital Devils here, but it's not worth it. They're leaving the base empty.
Yeah, it's exposed as well, but Hellcurt got caught off guard as Zania was able to sword spike right onto him and follow up with the Shadow Blade Slaughter, dealing enough damage for him to go down. But look at this, there's going to be the Lord contest coming from DDPG, but the players from RRQ is not just going to give them for free, as there is, look at that, the Nominon Blaster onto that Flicker, but there is a Ghost Pathway right in the middle, as a lot of the RRQ players are trying to swarm up here, but he was able to get the damage with his own and the battle execution. There is a Force Wing coming from Yakko, the Rotary Impact trying to push it out. There is Yakko here trying to kill. I am Jago, the Rotary Impact wasn't able to get the kill, but the Zania is able to get the killing spree as well there. And now, the double kill coming from the Zania will be able to clear out the players from RRQ as they are going to push on top lane, the one lane that is exposed with two super minions pushing in as only I am Jago and flashing in as only I am Jago and Liam. This is going to be a lot of issue for RRQ as they have to be able to hold this down. There is the Nominon Blast through the Flicker, will able to get the kill. The stun onto Liam as look at this. Liam is in a lot of issue trying to save the Ghost, by the way, for that extra heal as Zania has to run back because everyone else from Team RRQ has already respawned.
But Zania already got an immortality, so he can actually accompany Lord and try to make the final push all the way to the Nexus here. Or they will focus on the tier 2 and make more
turrets now.
Yeah, and so more super minion coming into the mid lane as well.
The interesting part with the Lord is that they have to cater onto that Lord, so DDPG can actually push the other lanes as they're trying to put. They can't put 5 men right onto that bot lane because they have someone to handle the Lord in top lane. So it's going to be a 4v5 if the fight actually happens, as Lyman with the Glorious Pathway try to stop the advance of the players from DDPG. Instinct here will try to get a bit out of the top lane, but RRQ is in a lot of trouble as the gold lane now is getting way further. There's a 19 deficit right now. DDPG is on a roll, is on the prime position, almost winning. There is the Mortal Coil, be able to stun 3 people. There is a knockup as well, but look at that, a lot of messy fights here as there's a Nominon Blast being charged by Lolita, and the Zania was able to get the Mega Kill, and RRQ was able to get the kill as well there. And I think that's GG, as the player from RRQ is unable to defend it from the attacks of DDPG. Tuturi has to run away, but the exposed Nexus is gonna be there as Tuturi got wiped out, and that is gonna be a GG for DDPG. And RRQ has to run down onto the bronze match, will face Errol in an Indonesian derby. But this is interesting though, the two teams that's gonna be in the finals is the two teams that's gonna be in the finals for MPL Philippines. Are we gonna see a rewind of that show, because Errol lost and RRQ lost. It's gonna be an Aether main going against DDPG. Aether main swept DDPG in a 3-0 score.
Wow, it's a really. DDPG is just playing super beautifully. I'm pretty sure that all the Filipinos supporter here, or everywhere else watching us at EGG Network or our Facebook Live gaming here, is going to be very ecstatic. So we're gonna see all Filipino team fighting at the grand finals here.
But